Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel Simplified Basic Concepts. In this video, I'm going to discuss about the training methods. This is the video of the staffing series. Prior to this video, in the staffing series, I have discussed about staffing and the three elements of staffing, which is recruitment, selection, training and development. I'll be just giving a glimpse about training and development because I have discussed in details about training and development in my previous video. So training and development is basically an educational tool which is used to provide information and instructions which can sharpen and improve the performance and skills of the employee while they are working. If in market there is some new concept, then regarding that also training and development is given to the employees. So basically the training is imparted to the employees to enhance their work performance. And often the training and development is used to motivate employees to improve their organizational commitment and at times to attract new talent towards the organization by publicizing the HRD efforts. HRD means human resource development efforts. At times it happens that when an organization shows its commitment towards the training and development of its employee, then the new talent gets attracted towards such organization because they feel that the employee is committed towards the enhancement, growth and improvement of the skills of an employee, right? Now, a large variety of methods of trainings are used in business. Even within one organization, there are different methods of training which is used for different employees. So in this video, I'll be discussing about the different types of training methods. So all the methods of training can be broadly divided into two major parts, which are on-the-job training methods and off-the-job training methods. So in on-the-job training method, as its name says, the training is imparted to the employee while he is working, right? So the training is imparted on the same machines or on the same type of machines where the employee will actually work. And these type of training methods do not actually cost much and they are very less disruptive. Disruptive means there is no disruption. There is no break in the work as the employees are always on the job. So in this type of training method, the employees don't go anywhere. They perform their routine job and while doing the routine job, they get training, right? That is why this method is called as learning while earning, because here an employee is earning by doing his regular job, plus he is learning new things when he is getting the training. Whereas in off-the-job training method, a specific location is being designated where the training is imparted to the employee. Now, the place where the training will be given can be near the workplace or the workstation of the employee, or it can be away from the workstation. That depends on the management. Now, conducting such training which is away from the workplace minimizes the distraction of the employees and it allows the employees or the trainees to devote their full attention on the training program, right? Now, what are the different methods by which on-the-job training is imparted to an employee? So the different methods are coaching, apprenticeship, understudy, job rotation, and job instruction technology. So let's understand this one by one. The first one is coaching, which is one-on-one training. That is, one supervisor or one coach is there who provides training to one employee. Now, here the supervisor who functions as a coach provides training to the individual, that is, to the trainee. And what he does, he points out or identifies the weak areas of the employee or of the trainee and focuses it, right? And provides feedback to the trainee on his performance and suggests the ways by which he can improve his performance. So this is a simple method in which a training is provided by the person who is his supervisor and who functions as a coach of the trainee, and he points out the weak areas of the trainee and tells him the ways by which he can improve his performance. But the only limitation is that the trainee may not have so much of liberty or freedom to express his own ideas, right? Now, the next method is job instructional technique. Now, this is step-by-step structured on the job training method. Here, the basic focus of the trainer is to demonstrate the task or the work to the trainee. So the trainer here actually performs the entire work, that is the role, and shows the trainee ways of doing the job. Once he does the job, and then he says the trainee to perform the same job. Here the trainer is practically doing the job and showing it to the trainee, and then he says the trainee to demonstrate and perform the same job. And if he finds that there is some problem or flaw in the way in which the trainee is doing, then he corrects those problems. So this is the way in which training is imparted here. The trainees here are presented with the learning material in written. So with the help of the written learning material, the trainee can later on also refer back to the steps which are written on it or mentioned on it, right? The trainer appraises the performance of the trainee and provides feedback information and corrects the trainee, right? So here the basic focus of the training is on the way in which the job is done. That is the way in which the job is done. What are the steps? What are the basic knowledge of doing the job? Basic training is imparted regarding to that. Now, this training program, that is apprenticeship training program, is for individuals or for those employees who desire to become experts in specific trade or crafts. See, there are certain pattern design makers or mechanic or tool makers, craftsmen, printers who basically do a specific type of job. So when these people or when these employee want to gain expertise in their field, then they are given apprenticeship training. Now this apprenticeship training could be compared to classroom learning, right? But the only difference is that in this apprenticeship training, along with classroom training type environment, the salary is also given to the employee. So here the training is administered by the seasoned tradesman or craftsman, that is people who are expert in their field, provide training to the employees who want to become expert in their trade or craft, right? And the person completing the apprenticeship training is known as apprentice, and this individual learns all the necessary skills of his or her chosen trade. Then comes understudy. Understudy basically refers to the method in which the trainees are prepared to perform the work or fill the position of their superior. That is, one person who is at a lower level will be provided training so that he can be in future or later on perform the work of his superior, right? So in this technique, a trainee assumes all the full duties and responsibilities of his or her superior. So the basic purpose here to provide this type of training is to prepare a subordinate, right? So that in future he can take up all the responsibilities and duties of his superior. So in future, when the superior vacates his position, the subordinate at that time is prepared to take up the position of his superior because he is very well aware about the responsibilities and duties of his superior. Here a subordinate closely observes how his superior works, what are his day-to-day problems, how does he handle those problems, and by observing and by the experience, the subordinate learns all the duties and responsibilities of the superior. Right. Now, the understudy fills the position of his or her superior that is about to leave the job, and the position can be vacant in situations such as promotion, retirement, or transfer. Right. So let's understand this with the help of an example, that the departmental head may pick up one competent person from the department to become his or her understudy. Now this gives the understudy an opportunity to try out his or her leadership skills. Right. Now, while recruitment, we discussed about the two ways in which recruitment can be done. One was external way and the other was internal source of recruitment. So in internal source of recruitment, we discussed that an employee who is already working in an organization can fill up the vacant position, right? So, what does organization do? They already know that the positions in future will be vacant. So, to fill those positions internally, understudy training is provided. Right. So, here what does the organization do? They prepare a subordinate to take up the responsibility of his or her superior who is about to leave his job. Maybe for any reason. Maybe the superior is getting promoted, or the superior is leaving the position because of retirement, or maybe he is getting transferred to some other position. But anyhow, if there will be the position vacant of the superior, there is already a subordinate ready to take up his responsibilities and duties. So this is the basic purpose of understudy training method. Then comes job rotation. Now here the training is done by rotating the employees through a series of related jobs. See, job rotation means it is a process of training the employees by rotating them through a series of related jobs, right? Rotation not only makes a person very well know about the different jobs, but it also elevates or removes the boredom and allows to develop rapport between a number of people. So rotation must be logical, right? So job rotation means when a person working on a job is shifted to other related job, right? Now this is very important point, that rotation must be logical. That is, a person from finance department cannot be rotated and be given the job responsibilities of HR department. No, this can't be done. Rotation must always be logical. That is, a person who is working in one department may be shifted or rotated to such job which is related to the skills which has, right? So a person from finance department will be changed or shifted to such job where his skills can be used. So a person from one department cannot be shifted to other department in the name of job rotation. But even if there is shifting or job rotation, then there must be related jobs. That is, the jobs which require same types of skills, same types of qualifications. Only on those type of jobs, job rotation of the employees can be done. Right. Now, this type of trainee involves the movement of the trainee from one job to another. Right. And the trainee receives job knowledge and gains experience from his supervisor or trainer in each of the different job assignment. So, a person who is working in finance department on one post or on one profile may be shifted to some other job profile which again requires the same skills which he has or related skills to finance, but there may be some new skills to added to the same profile, right? Because in finance department, all the person working are not working on the same profile. They're having slightly different job roles and job profiles. So when a person is shifted from one job profile to another job profile, then there is a chance or there is a probability where he can get to learn new skills. And the trainer here helps in giving the more job knowledge and experience to the trainee who is rotated on the new job. Right. So this method gives an opportunity to the trainee to understand the problem of employees on the other jobs. Now, at times it happens that when an employee is working on one job profile, he is totally unaware what are the problems, what are the opportunities of the other job profile. Right. So till the time one doesn't get an idea or one doesn't work on the profile, the employee will not have an idea. This training method, does this job rotation, helps an employee in understanding each and every role of the job. What are the advantages of on-the-job training methods? See, on-the-job training method is directly related to the context of job, and it is often informal. That is, the on-the-job training method is not given in a very formal atmosphere, and it is very cost effective because it is learning by experience. That is, when an employee is working on a job, then only training is imparted to him by different ways. That is, in understudy on-the-job training method, we saw that a subordinate is being prepared to take up responsibility for his superior while he is working. In job rotation, we saw that here the training is provided by shifting one employee from one job to other job. In coaching, we saw that a supervisor is imparting training to an employee and showing him the ways by which he can improve his performance. In job instruction training, we saw that an employee is given training about the steps, about the ways in which he can correctly do a job. So in each of on the job training method, we saw that all the trainees, all the employees are gaining experiences while they are working on the job. So it's earning while learning, right? And this is very less expensive because the trainees are not leaving their workplace. There is no money required or there is no setup, extra setup requirement for on the job training method. That is why it is very less expensive. And the trainees here are highly motivated and it is free from artificial classroom situation. That is, here the trainees don't have to go and attend a classroom sort of session for receiving training, which at times becomes very boring. Here an employee goes to his workplace, does his daily job, and along with doing his job, he is getting extra knowledge. That is why it is said that the trainees here are highly motivated. So these were few of the advantages of on-the-job training method. And now the disadvantages. The trainer may not be experienced enough to train, right? This is one of the disadvantages. Second is, this training method may not be systematically organized, because we know that the on-the-job training method is provided in very informal conditions, right? There is no formal setup or no formal rules for providing on-the-job training. So at times it's not very systematically organized. One of the disadvantages of on-the-job training method is that if this training method is poorly conducted, then it may create safety hazards, right? Now we know that training is imparted to give knowledge, to provide knowledge which is related to work. Right. So if an employee doesn't get proper training, or if the training program is poorly conducted, that is, the training program is not able to impart proper knowledge to the employee. And if an employee doesn't have proper knowledge of doing the work, then he may harm himself. So that there is a very big safety issue in this case, because here all the time the employees are directly working on the machineries at the workplace, right? So they are at the actual site of the work. So if they don't have proper knowledge, create safety problems. Now, what are off the job training methods? So few of off the job training methods are lectures and conferences, vestibule training, management games, role play, case studies, and in basket exercises. We know that off the job training means that the employees are provided training which is not at the workplace. That is, there is a separate place which is not the actual place where the employees work, right? It is off the job. The first one in off the job training method is classroom lectures and conferences. Now this is the most traditional and direct way of providing training. It's generally used to train the white collar or managerial level employees in the organization. This method is used to provide training by the trainer in the form of lectures in classroom like place, right? So like in classroom, we used to get lectures in our colleges. In the same way here, the training is provided in the form of lectures. Verbal presentations are given to large audiences at a time, and the speaker here must have in-depth knowledge. So classroom lectures or conferences are the same way in which the lectures were given when we were in college or schools. Here too, the trainers provide lectures to the trainees. So under this method, the employees are provided training by the trainer in the form of lectures, and it's a verbal presentation for large audience. That is, many employees can attend classroom lectures and conferences in off the job training method. The speaker in off the job training method providing classroom lectures and conferences must have in-depth knowledge about the subject, because they are verbally explaining the trainees, right? So they need to have in-depth knowledge. Method is effectively used to make aware of the procedure and to give instructions on particular topic, right? Now, the next method is vestibule training. This is provided to employees when new or advanced equipments are introduced in the organization to do a particular job by using them, right? So whenever there is a new or advanced equipments introduced in the organization, then vestibule training is provided to the employees. So here the employees are not allowed to straight away go and start working on these new or advanced equipments. Prior to working, they are given a theoretical training where they are brought to a separate place and a demonstration is given to the employees, right? So here what is done, the equipment, that is the newer advanced equipment, is brought to a separate place and demonstration is given on them. That is, the employees are shown how to work on them. So the employees here are not allowed to directly work on them. The trainers will show the employees how to work. So here the workers are trained in a prototype environment on the specific job. Prototype environment means copy of an actual environment is shown. So by seeing here, the trainees have to learn how to actually work. So here an attempt is made to create working condition similar to the actual workshop conditions. After training workers in such conditions, the trained workers may be put on similar job in the actual workshop. So the duration of such training ranges from few days to few weeks, and it prevents the trainees to commit costly mistakes on actual machines, right? So whenever a newer advanced equipment is introduced in the organization, vestibule training is provided. That is, a trainer here shows how to work on the equipment. So the trainees get to know how to work on the actual equipment by seeing how the trainer is performing the job. Right, so here the workers are trained in a prototype environment. Prototype environment means that is not the actual workplace. A similar type of workplace setup is being created and the machine is kept there. The trainer works on that machine and shows how the employee, when he'll go to actual workplace, how he can work. Right. So after training workers in such conditions, the trained worker may be put on similar jobs. So after receiving the training only, the workers can work on the actual equipments so that they may not commit any costly mistakes on the newer advanced equipments. And such training ranges from few weeks to few days. Right. Now then comes simulation training method. See what happens that before appearing for anything new, it's better if we get an idea about it. Right. So simulation helps in that before appearing in the actual situation, an artificial environment is created which is very similar to the actual situation, just like in case of pre-board and board exams. Now the pre-board and board exams are very different, but in pre-board examinations the students get an idea how to write examination, what are the time constraints, right, everything. So pre-board is a sort of artificial environment which is exactly similar to the board situation. So this can be an example of simulation. In simulation training method, what is done here, an artificial environment is created, right, which is very similar to the actual situation. What happens when some new machineries or new equipments are brought in the organization, and these machineries are very expensive. So the organization doesn't want that the employee who doesn't know how to handle it directly starts working on it, right? Because if they'll directly start working on it, they can damage it, right? So just to prevent these expensive machineries from the damages which they can get from inexperienced employees, the employees are first provided trainings how to work on these machineries. So where will these employees get trainings? So to provide training, a very similar sort of equipment or machinery is created, right, which is very similar to the new machinery. So this similar type of machinery and equipment is designed just to provide training to the trainees so that the trainees may get an idea how to handle these machineries, how to work on them, and then only they are allowed to touch those machineries and work on these equipments, right? Now the four basic simulation training techniques are management games, case study, role play, and in-basket training method. So the management games basically focus on the practical applicability of the subject. Different games are used for training general managers, middle management, and functional heads. The trainees here are divided into 5 or 6 persons group, each of which competes with the other in a very simulated environment. Simulated environment means artificial environment, which is very close to the actual environment, that is, which is very similar to the actual workplace. And here the groups will decide that how much they want to spend, how much they want to spend on producing, advertising, how can they maintain inventory, and how much of the products they need to produce. So these type of management games help the trainees to develop the problem solving skills, to focus attention on planning, and the group usually elects their own officers, which can develop leadership skills and teamwork. Right. So management games are sort of games which are different for training the general managers, middle management, and functional head. Here basically 5 to 6 persons group are made, and each group make their own plans, make their own strategies, show their own strategy, how they can spend on advertising, producing, and everything about the management. Second method is case study method. In case study method, what happens? Certain examples, certain situations are given to the trainees, and they are asked how will they deal with this situation. Like a plot is given or situation is given that in case there are 10 workers working in an organization in one department, and all of a sudden while having lunch they start fighting. Right. So how will an employee deal with such situation? Right. So case studies are actually certain situations which are given to the employee, and they are asked how can they deal with such situations. Now these situations are given to the employee based on their job profiles. Right. So case studies are complex examples which gives an insight into the context of problems. So, the case studies are basically trainee-centered activities based on the topics that demonstrates theoretical concepts in an applied setting. Right? If an employee is working on a certain profile, then related to his job profile only, a certain situation will be created and he will be asked to show his point, like how will he deal with such situation. Okay, now case study allows the application of theoretical concepts, which helps in bridging the gap between theory and practice. And these sort of training methods encourages active learning, and it provides opportunity for the development of skill such as communication, group work, problem solving, and helps the training to enhance their desire to learn. So in case study, there may be a group or an individual is given a certain situation, a certain plot related to his job profiles, and he is asked that how will he deal with such situation. Now when an employee here or a trainee here puts forward his point of view, then first of all, the basic thing which is activated here is skill of communication. That is, the hesitation which is there in an employee or in a trainee, that is reduced to an extent, because here he starts communicating, he starts expressing his ideas. Right. Secondly, if the case study is presented in group and a group is said to tackle the situation, then employees learn how to work in group and how to come to a conclusion while taking in consideration everybody's point. Right. It enhances the problem solving techniques of an individual. Third simulation technique is role play. During a role play, the trainee assumes the role and acts out that situation connected to the learning concept. Now, this method is also called as role reversal, sociodrama, or psychodrama. So the role play is very similar to a drama, but the only difference is here, there is no written lines. It should be naturally, right? There is no rehearsal. That is, very quick response is being expected from the trainees who are performing this, right? So the role players have to respond quickly to the situation that is ever changing and to react to it as they would do in real situation. See, in real situation or in real workplace, there are many things which come spontaneously in day-to-day workplace, right? So just to enhance those skills as to what an employee will do if such situations come while they are working, how can they deal with them? Role playing helps in these things. So it is a method of human interaction which involves realistic behavior in an imaginary or hypothetical situation. So role playing primarily involves employer-employee relationship, hiring, firing, discussing a grievance problem, right? So what happens in role playing is certain situation is given to the employee and he is said to play the role in that situation, right? So let's understand that there is an employee and he said that as soon as he comes to his office, 3 or 4 of his subordinates resigned at a time. So how is he going to deal with this situation? Now, when these type of trainings are provided to the trainees or to the employees, they get an idea how can they deal with these situations. They get to know other people's idea also, the other trainees' idea. They get to know the feedback as to what they are thinking is actually in true line or not. Now, in-basket training is also known as in-tray training. It places the trainees in real work-like situation. It is a method in which new or promoted employees get to know the complexities of their job, the range of problems they may have, their day-to-day routine, and how are they going to deal with these things, right? When a new employee joins the organization, he has theoretical knowledge about his job profile, right? He actually doesn't know how things are working in this organization. So in this in-basket training, what happens here that a real-life situation is created for the employee and he is given all those tasks and jobs which he has to do in a day, right? He has to conduct sessions, he has to talk to clients, he has to do X, he has to do Y, he has to do Z. So there are 10 number of things which he has to do in a day, right? So all these tasks which he has to perform in a day is being given to him. And the thing which is seen here is that how the trainee or the new employee is going to. Now the thing which is seen here is that how or what are the tasks which the new employee will prioritize and to which tasks will he give importance and how will he manage his day-to-day work, right? So by getting these type of training, what will happen? The new employee will get an idea. How can he prioritize? And in case if he is not able to manage things, not able to prioritize, then his trainer will give him training. How can he do that, right? So when the new joinee will actually start working, then by that time he will have a complete idea how can he manage his jobs. Or else what will happen, the new trainee or the new employee will find himself in complete messed up situation because he won't be able to manage everything at the new workplace at a time. So this in-basket training is very important for new joinees because it gives them complete idea how can they prioritize their work, to which task they need to give importance, and how can they do their job effectively and efficiently, right? So the trainees here is given the log of materials that make up the in-basket, and then they are asked to prioritize the decisions to be made immediately and the ones that can be delayed, right? Here the trainees receives the number of mails, telephone calls, documents, memos which they'll be receiving in their actual job profile in day-to-day work. In basket here means the problems or the tasks which the employee have to manage every day, that is those tasks which are kept on his desk, right? So as the employee solve these problems, he or she transfers them to the out basket. Now, what are advantages of off-the-job training? This increases the productivity. Off-the-job training is conducted outside the workstation, so the trainees are not involved in the production process. Only skilled workers are placed at the workplace, so the productivity is not hampered, it increases. Second advantage is it minimizes errors. Here, the new employees are trained outside the production area, so only skilled employees work at the actual workplace on the actual machineries, so there are very less problem of safety hazards and it lowers the production error too. Third is no disturbance. That is, here the production process is not disturbed as the trainees are not allowed to work in the actual workplace and the existing employees can do their job very smoothly. And the disadvantages of off-the-job training is it is very expensive training method due to extra space, accommodation, transportation cost and experts fee which is required in conducting such trainings. Off-the-job training method is less effective than on-the-job training method because it is conducted outside the work environment. So here the employees doesn't get the feel of actual workplace. Employees need extra induction training to handle their job even after off-the-job training method, right? Then comes dissatisfaction. That is, the training is conducted artificially outside the workplace. So the employees cannot learn properly in this training method. So dissatisfaction at times arises in among the employees. And the last one is the trainees cannot take part in the production process. So potential output and time is lost in the method of off-the-job training method. Now let's see what is the difference between on-the-job training and off-the-job training. As its name suggests, on-the-job training method refers to a form of training which is provided at the workplace during the performance of actual job. And off-the-job training method is provided when the employees are given training actually outside the workplace. On-the-job training has a very practical approach because here the employees directly work at their workplace, whereas off-the-job training method has very theoretical approach. In on-the-job training method, there is active participation of the members because here the employees are actually working on the machineries or at their workplace and learning. So they are actively participating. But in off-the-job training method, there is no active participation, as in off-the-job training method, it's mostly the employees sit and they get the training from the trainer theoretically, right? On the job training method, the training is given at the workplace, whereas in off the job training method, the location of training is away from the workplace. In on the job training method, there is no work disruption. That is, here the trainees are working throughout the time, even while getting the training. They are not discontinuing their job, right? So there is no break in their job. Whereas in off-the-job training method, there is work disruption because first the training is provided to the employee, then only they are allowed to work at the actual workplace. The training program in on-the-job training is very less expensive, whereas the training program in off-the-job training is very expensive. And on-the-job training method is most suitable for manufacturing firm and off-the-job training method is suitable for non-manufacturing firms, right? So these were the differences between on-the-job and off-the-job trainings. So with this, I come to the end of this. Do like and subscribe my channel, which is Simplified Basic Concepts. Thank you.